an unnecessary journey round Whole Foods. An unnecessary journey round Whole Foods. This is one of my favourite buildings, but one of my least favourite shops. I am, and will never be, their clientele, but I'm going to have a look in there anyway. Due to music playing in the background, I'm going to have to do a lot of voiceover for this episode. Now, the reason why I never really liked Whole Foods, or Whole Foods as I like to pronounce it, is because I just found it as really pretentious. When I first moved to London back in 2010, I went in to Whole Foods and I just found it really pretentious and really overpriced for it was. I didn't find the staff particularly very nice either. They didn't seem to be very happy at all. And it really just looked as if it was just a huge health food shop, which are generally staffed by miserable people. They never seem to be that happy. I don't know what it is. And so that was my perception of Whole Foods. I just didn't like it at all. And I thought it really was a rich people just shopped somewhere where they got their expensive food from. And I suppose maybe it didn't help that the customer clientele was generally quite rude to them, so it would have made them miserable. So that's my reasons for originally having this opinion of Whole Foods. It's a really big shop. According to Wikipedia, it's still Whole Foods' biggest shop. This one in Kensington High Street, or High Street Kensington as it likes to be called. I do like the escalators here. It's got an escalator for the trolleys. Because it's over three floors, it's a huge shop. Even the escalator helps the trolleys. Going into the fruit section now, which is really nice. It's really nicely set out and displayed. It's huge. But there's still that hint of pretentiousness still there. Not as bad as it used to be. I think Amazon are really trying to actually get some sales out of this shop now. So what you'll find now is a lot more normality in the sense of food rather than pretentiousness. But it still exists. You still get things that you think, oh, why? What is that for? The example of stupidity is that bottle of stuff we saw there with coriander. I think it was shoved into it. And then they're still trying to flog these coconuts with the ring pull in the top of them. You see, they've gone now. I think they're over. I think they should stop pushing that stuff and just keep doing with what they actually do well. I've got to say, my experience this time was a lot better than it usually is. I think there's been a lot of changes over the past year that are really improving the shopability of going into Whole Foods.
Yellow courgettes, never seen yellow courgettes before. Aubergine. Graffiti aubergine. Snurbergine.
I was actually recording this about 2 to 3 o'clock in the afternoon. The shop was really nice and tidy. They did have a delivery coming later on, you'll see that in the video. But everything was really nice and tidy and nice looking and really well presented. Which is difficult, especially of where this shop is. I mean, it's High Street Kensington, so you'd expect it to be busy. It was busier than I expected it to be, but it was really nice and tidy. So that was good. Oh, and clean, very clean. Thank you.
I love these little tomatoes. But I won't be able to afford $11.99 a kilogram. That is a lot.
Yeah, the pricing of the things in Whole Foods is obviously expensive. I think the prices are more of a formality than actual, this is what we are. Because it really is still a place of people with money would shop at, or where people with money would send their staff out to go and buy things. I do have, though, a strange better feeling of being in Whole Foods today. When I was there, I didn't feel as oppressed in a funny sort of way, and I don't know why. Something just seemed better. Obviously, by saying that, this is not a paid for promotion by Whole Foods or Amazon or anybody like that. It's definitely not. This is just my observations of going into Whole Foods on my own. I was wondering what was happening with Whole Foods, though, because Amazon took it over and they've had it for over a year now. And I was thinking maybe if the Sainsbury's and Asda merger had gone through, that some of the forced sell-off of stores, maybe Amazon would have bought a few and converted to Whole Foods. I don't know. But there's no expansion that's happened, which is quite strange. Maybe they are just going to keep it this small, and maybe they are going to use it for eventually for supplying the food through the Amazon delivery service. It's almost as if Amazon don't really know what they're going to do with it yet.
Snickerdoodle. Cookie dough. Well, there's a lot of quite a music around here. So I'll be able to speak at this bit. Milk. Where do I get milk from? Oh, this is all these iced coffees at the top. I'm not into this cold cosmarchy. Even though that monster one was nice, I don't think I'm going to find it here. Oh, kombucha. Jasmine pearl tea.
Whole Foods didn't have the greatest time before its takeover by Amazon. If you look up the Wikipedia, there's quite a lengthy piece on controversies that Whole Foods had.
Rude health. How rude.
You'll have to let me know in the comment section down below. Is this what whole? Is this what all Whole Foods look like? There's also a really nice smell in Whole Foods. It's got a lovely, nice, fresh food smell. Whether it's fresh fruit and veg or meat.
Never tried duck eggs.
Spot the odd one out. I don't need to buy some eggs. Eggs, 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 eggs. Did I get any eggs from here? Juice. Yeah.
Oh, it's got ginger in it. Gooseberry jam. Passion fruit curd. Lemon curd. Ooh, lamb. Lamb marmalade. Tub of peanut butter, but went to that Elf food shop and got it for £1.50, maybe £2 cheaper. Sugar. We offer 100% satisfaction or your money back, no questions asked. Well, I'll have to put that to test, won't I? Yeah, this is one of the bigger Whole Foods, obviously. You've gathered that by now, I think. And when I think of Whole Foods, because this is the first one I ever went into, I always think of this one, but I don't know if it's the same in America or not.
In a minute, you're going to see me pick up some Reese's Pieces knockoff, which is these peanut butter cup things, and they're really nice. I'm eating them right now. Mmm! As are these chestnuts. I ate the chestnuts on the bus on the way home.
Love chestnuts. I'm going to get them. £1.29.
Now, you may be wondering at this juncture, is this really an unnecessary journey to Whole Foods? Because I'm filming it and I'm buying stuff. Well, yeah, it is an unnecessary journey to Whole Foods. Whole Foods is nowhere near me. I had to get on, well, I didn't need to get two buses to get there, but I got on two buses to get there. Because I didn't feel like walking in the rain. Sorry, I'm just getting the rest of them peanut butter cups out of my mouth. You'll see them in a minute. I buy some. They're really nice. Also, I'm doing a lot of talking now because there is an awful lot of music playing around here. And I don't want to get a strike from YouTube for copyright, blah, blah, blah.
Original sustainable water bottle. Oh, pays 25 quid for melamine. We've got to try that, Anna. Yeah. Oh my god. Oh. I thought I was paying £4 for bog roll, like. How much are you paying for this toilet roll? Well, it's still just about £2.79. Or is it £1.99? £2.49. No, £1.99. Oh, I don't know. The pricing's a bit off here, isn't it? And Stu, I suppose this is the kind of place where the price tickets are just a formality. I don't think people who shop at Whole Foods worry about price too much.
Of course, the only time Whole Foods really did start to struggle was during the financial crisis of 2008. I don't know why it's got a special name. It was a recession, largely caused by American and British banks, you know, this subprime mortgage market, whatever it was that. Loads of businesses shut, loads of innocent people lost their jobs in companies that started collapsing because, thanks to the banks, who got bailed out. And it wasn't just American banks, it was British ones as well.
Degradable poop banks. 270 unscented bags. Well, I'm sorry that if you're picking up your dog poo, I think you want a bit of scentedness going on.
Another note about these pretentiousness things. There's too many of these bottles, these reusable bottles. There's loads of them that are just likely to get forgotten in a shop, then they end up getting chucked away. This is not helping.
This is where it gets all the yellow food stuff in it. Ooh, soap. Smells nice. Thank you. course, it's owned by Amazon now, isn't it, Whole Foods? So, we're going to get all this stuff on Amazon eventually. No, it doesn't smell. You're burning the tub. Oh dear, clean up an aisle one. Grab some of this.
Yeah, they're the ones I've just finished eating. The hazelnut ones that I hope to review on Tuesday. Some kind of posh Kinder Surprise, I think.
Both lifts are out of order.
Yeah, sorry, it's not working.
Oh, yeah, just neither of them are. You're alright. They're just getting maintained. I mean, it's old foods, isn't it? I don't think both lifts are going to be out of order because of anything bad. It's just because of maintenance.
Yeah, this is where they sell cheese behind them closed doors. It's not very inviting though. I think we should have an electric door there or something. I mean, it's going to be quite whiffy in there. To the cheesery? Is that what you call a place that sells just cheese? A cheesery? There is quite an extensive boozery and winery. There's loads of different kinds of beers and wines and all sorts of stuff. It is quite substantial. It is definitely somewhere I think someone of money would definitely go if they were entertaining and wanting to get some good wine.
Somebody likes to grill the mushrooms. They're all gone.
But
never been upstairs before. Not in here anyway. Is it a cafe or something? Go up there another day. I'm gonna buy this stuff and go now.
Big that Old Foods is. I hope you enjoyed my random, pointless journey around it. Unnecessary journey around Old Foods.
That was my pointless walk around Whole Foods. Unnecessary journey around Old Foods. I've never been to the upstairs bit before, but I'll have to have a better look up there another day. And it was all like little, it was like a food court sort of thing, but a posh one. So it had a sushi thing, and it had all that sort of, yeah. That's the longest I've actually been in there. All the staff are lovely. My first couple of times I went into Whole Foods, I didn't think the customer service was all that. So something's definitely changed in the last year or so. It's a lot better, because it didn't used to be like that. I'm glad it seems to be more friendly in there. So my opinion of Whole Foods might be actually changing. I don't know. Do I think we'll ever shopping in there again? Well, yeah, of course. I like getting random stuff, but I'll have to get it another time. I spent £10 in there getting that weird egg thing, the toilet roll with pandas on it, them peanut butter chocolate things, and what else did I get? Oh, what did I get? Well, it's like that game, isn't it? Aunt Sally went shopping and bought something, and you got to remember the different letters of the alphabet. What else did I get? Oh, well, I got some at dinner. Anyway, thanks for watching. Please scrass. Let me know in the comment section down below anything you want to know. Don't forget to bell me. Bye.